continue the 7th chapter, that is landforms and the water bodies. Okay children, so in the previous class children, we learned about the continents and the oceans. Okay, so today in this class we will learn about the landforms. Children, now I ask the questions. What kind of the landform, what kind of the land is present your surrounding, which means children, around your house or a school. Okay, what kind of the land is present, children? Think once again. Okay, so is it flat, is it hilly, or are there any water bodies, children? Think. So why I asked this question, children? Because the land, okay, the land covering the earth surface, it is not uniform, children. Okay, in the some places the land is, it is a hilly area. Okay, and in other places it is a flat. Okay, and others there are the water bodies. Okay, so the different features, the earth surface, it has a different features. So what are the landforms? What are the landforms, children? The different features that make up the earth surface, they are called the landforms. Which are they, children? The landforms, different landforms are the mountains, plateaus, plains, and the deserts, etc. Okay, so these landforms are natural features. Okay, and some landforms are, children, formed by the act or force of the water, air, and the ice. Okay, children, today in this class, let's we study about the mountains. Okay, mountains. Mountains. Do you know that, children? Mountains, hills. Yes? So, the mountains and hills are the rocky masses of the land. Mountains and hills are the rocky masses of the land that rise higher than the surrounding. Okay, so the mountains and the rock hills are the rocky masses of the land that higher than the surrounding areas. Okay, so children, what is the difference between the mountains and the hills? What is the difference, children? Mountains are very high. Yes, high landform. Then mountains have the slopes. Then mountains have the peaks, children. Okay, but hills, compared to the mountains, the hills are smaller and the lower. Okay, okay, children. A mountain is a huge mass of the land. Okay, then which rises higher than the general level of the surrounding areas. Okay, the mountains, it is a huge mass of the land, children. Okay, it rises, okay, or rises higher or rises above than the general level of the surrounding areas. So it is a general level of the surrounding areas. Okay, so mountains, these are the huge mass of the land that rises higher. Okay, then also the mountains have the steep sides, children. These are known as the steep sides. Okay, are called the slopes. Okay, and mountain has the peak, tip of the mountain, it is known as the peak, children. Tip of the mountain, it is known as a, children, mountains have the steep sides. Okay, these are called the slopes. Okay, and tip of the mountain, it is called the peak. Okay, children, what is the highest peak in the world? That is the Mount Everest. Okay, so the Mount Everest, it is the highest peak in the world. Mount Everest. Mount Everest, it is the highest peak in the world. Then how much height is, children? That is 8848 meters. Okay, 8848 848 meters, and it is located between the Nepal and the Tibet. Nepal and the Tibet. So children, now I show the mountains. Okay, so here in the map, observe here what you are observing, the brown color. Okay, these are the mountains. Okay, Himalayan mountain. So here the Mount Everest, it lies between the Tibet and the Nepal. So children, the Indian states, Himalayan region. Okay, it covers the Indian states are the Jammu Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand. Okay, then Bihar, Sikkim, then Bhutan, Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, Manipur, Mizoram. Okay, these all states. Then how the mountains are formed, children? How the mountains are formed? The mountains, okay, mountains are formed as a result of the movements inside the earth. Okay, so mountains do not stand alone, children. Okay, mountains do not stand generally alone. Okay, like means generally alone means we found the mountains along with the chains, which means, children, so mountains, one mountain joined to the another. Okay, one mountain joined to the another, like this type. Okay, the mountains do not stand alone. Okay, so the one mountain is joined to the another mountain, that is known as a chain. Such a chain, it is known as a mountain ranges. Okay, mountain ranges. Mountain ranges. Oh, then the Himalayan range. Okay, the Himalayan range, it is the highest mountain range in the world, children. Then other most important mountain ranges are the Alps. Where is it, children? The Alps, it is in the Europe. Okay, then the Rockies in the North America. Then Andes mountain range, it is in the South America. So the Himalayan range, it is the highest mountain range in the world. Then do you know that, children, what are the fold mountains? Himalaya. Okay, Himalaya, it is known as a fold mountain. What is a fold mountain? The some mountains are formed when the two large landmass push against other. Okay, so the some mountains form, children, form when the two large landmass push against each other. They are called the fold mountains. For example, the Himalayan mountains. Okay, the Himalayan mountains, it is known as the fold mountains. Did you know, children, the high mountain ranges have the glaciers, which means covered by the ice, and slow moving rivers of the ice. Whenever the temperature increases, okay, then melts the snow. Then that mountains, okay, mountains having the slow moving ice, slow moving rivers of the ice. Okay, so the large rivers, children, the large rivers also originate in these mountains. Okay, the large rivers. Okay, for example, Ganga, Indus, Brahmaputra, these are the rivers originate in the Himalayas. Okay, originate in the Himalayan mountains. So like this type, the large rivers originate in the mountains. Then hills, children, what are the hills? Hill, it is a high landform, children. Hill also the high landform, but compared to the mountain, it is a smaller and the lower. Okay, children, the Aravali range and Nilgiri. The Aravali range and Nilgiri are the some of the hills found in India. In which state, children? The Aravali range. Okay, it lies in the Haryana and the Rajasthan. Okay, Haryana and the Rajasthan. Then Nilgiri hills, it lies in the western Ghats of Tamil Nadu. Okay, western ghats of the Tamil Nadu. So next point that is valley children. What are the valleys? So the low land between the two mountains or hills, they are called the valleys. So children, the low land between the two mountains or hills, so children, valleys or a valley, okay, it is a low land between the two mountains. These are the mountains, children. Okay, these are the mountains. It is a low land. Okay, it is a low land, children. Low land between the two mountains or low land between the two hills, that is known as a valley. Okay, then the river, the rivers originate in the mountains. The rivers originate in the mountains, often flow through these valleys, children. Okay, so some valleys they are broad. Okay, some valleys are they narrow. For example, the U-shaped or a V-shaped valleys also are there. Okay, very very narrow valleys are there, children. Okay, we have to try to understand, children. Valleys are the lowlands between the two mountains or hills are known as valleys. Then children, the broad valleys are inhabited by the people or inhabited by the population. Then the famous valleys in India are the Brahmaputra Valley and the Kashmir Valley. Okay, Brahmaputra Valley and the Kashmir Valley. So these valleys are the great scenic beauty and attract the tourist people, children. Okay, for example, the Kashmir Valley. Okay, the Valley of Kashmir, it is one of the most beautiful valley in the world. Okay, so the Kashmir Valley is the most beautiful valley in the world. Okay children, observe the chart. It is a picture of the mountain. Okay, already we learned what is a mountain, children. The mountain is a huge mass of the land. Okay, mountain, it is a huge mass of the land which higher than or rises higher than the surrounding areas. Okay, so the largest mountain, that is the largest or highest mountain range, that is a Himalayan mountain range, and the highest peak in the world, children, that is Mount Everest. Okay, so children, observe, this is a chart or a picture of the mountains. Okay, then let's learn about the plateaus. Okay, plateaus. What are the plateaus, children? Plateaus are also the highlands with the table like a broad and flat top. So children, the plateaus are also the high land form, but the top is, children, it is a broad and flat. Okay, now I show the chart of the plateaus. Observe here, it is a chart of the plateau, children. Observe, the plateaus are highlands. Okay, plateaus also highlands, but the top is, children, broad and flat. Okay, like a table. So here plateaus are highlands. Okay, in the different shapes, okay, we can see. So plateaus are also the highlands, then with the table like a flat and a broad top. So here the plateaus also have the steep slopes. Okay, plateaus also have the steep slopes. What is the first plateau, children? A large area of the land.
A large area of land.
A large area of the land that is higher than. That is higher than the surrounding.
Higher than the
higher than the surrounding.
Higher than the surrounding
are more or less
are more or
more or less flat at the top.
Flat at the top.
So what is a plateau, children? A large area of the land that is higher than the surrounding or more or less at the top.
Children, okay, that is, we can see like this type or like this type,
but the top is, children, flat like a table. So children, the plateaus are also called the table lands. Why the plateaus are also called the table lands, children? Because a plateau is level area of the land. The plateau is leveled area of the land, plain at the top like a table. Plain at the top. Which shape at the top, children? Okay, it is a flat, flat level. That's why the plateaus are also called the table lands. Then the plateau of Tibet, children. Okay, the plateau of Tibet, it is known as the roof of the world. Plateau of Tibet.
Plateau of Tibet
is known as the roof of the world.
Roof of the world.
Why, children? Why it is called the roof of the world? Because it is the highest plateau in the world. Okay, the plateau of Tibet, it is known as the roof of the world because it is highest plateau in the world. It is in north of the Himalayas, children. It is the Tibetan plateaus. It is north of the Himalayas. Okay, north of the Himalayas. Okay, the Tibetan plateaus lies north of the Himalayas. Then the Deccan Plateau, children, another one plateau is the Deccan Plateau. It is in the South India. Okay, so the Deccan Plateau, it is in the South India, children. Okay, South India. Then it covers entire Indian Peninsula. Okay, it covers entire Indian Peninsula. Okay, then the Chota Nagpur Plateau. It is in the India. Okay, so then the Pamir Plateau, where is it, children? It is in the Central Asia. These are the names of the plateaus. So in India, the Deccan Plateau. Okay, Deccan Plateau, it is a important plateau. Then the higher parts of the plateau, children, the higher part of the plateaus. Okay, the higher part of the plateaus have the cold climate. The higher part of the plateaus have the cold climate and have rich minerals. Okay, have a rich minerals, children, and suitable for the agriculture and animal rearing. Plateaus also useful for the growing a crops, means suitable for the agriculture and the and animal rearing. For example, Deccan Plateau, children. Okay, so Deccan Plateau. Then the plateaus are already I told, children, why the plateaus are called the table lands, because the plateau is a leveled area of the land, plain at the top. plane at the top, and the plateaus look like a table. That's why the plateaus are called the tablelands.
Okay, children. Now plains. Okay, the plains. It is also the different landform. Okay, the plains are flat. Children, the plains are flat land with the gentle slopes. Plains are also, children, the flat land with the gentle slopes. So observe the picture, children. This is a picture of the plains. Plains. So the where the rivers originate, children? Rivers originate in the mountains. Okay. So rivers flowing from the mountains bring the fertile soil to the valleys or plains. Okay. So large rivers, they originate in the mountains, then carry the that river water, carry the fertile soil and form the plains. Therefore, plains have more fertile and most populated area. So children, here the plains are more fertile land and most thickly populated areas in the world. Because why, children? Because the plains are more fertile and also the most populated. Okay, most inhabited. We can see in the plains. Okay, the plains are most inhabited by the people. Then how the plains form, children? Okay, how the plains form? How the form? Why I am asking this question, children? I told. Okay, the plains are more fertile. How the plains are formed, children? That is, the plains are watered by the rivers. That rivers, which rivers originate in the mountains. Okay, so here the plains are watered by the rivers which originate in the mountains. Along with the water, the rivers carry the broken bits of the rocks, sand and the soil, then silt deposited in the valley or plains. Okay, so children, this silt deposited, okay, this silt deposited by the rivers, it is called the alluvial soil. What is, children? Alluvial soil. Alluvial soil. When the rivers, where they originate, children? Rivers originate from in the mountains, then after flow. Okay, whenever the rivers flow, that water, okay, in the water, that water bring along with the soil, sand, okay, then the broken bits of the rocks, okay, silt, and where that deposit, that soil, it is known as a alluvial soil. It is, children, it is extremely very fertile and formed the plains. Okay, so the plains are watered by the rivers that originate in the mountains, then along with the water, the rivers carry the sand, soil, then the broken bits of the rocks, silt, okay, deposited in the plains. So here, this silt deposited by the rivers, it is known as alluvial soil, okay, which is by the rivers. And this soil, it is very fertile and formed the plains. For example, here, children, that is the northern plains. Okay, the northern plains. Okay, children, the northern plains. The northern plains formed by the river Ganga and its tributaries. Northern plains formed by the river Ganga and its tributaries. Ganga River, children, where it is originate? It is originate in the Himalayan mountain. Yes, children. So that's why the northern plains are very fertile. Then the northern plains of the India, and another one, children, that is prairies of the USA. Prairies of the USA produce a large amount of the wheat and other grains. Why, children? Because these plains are very fertile and most populated, most thickly inhabited by the people. Okay, so these plains more fertile than inhabited by the so many people. Okay children, today in this class what we learned, we discussed about the mountains. Okay, what is a mountain children? Mountain, it is a huge mass of the land, okay, which rises higher than the surrounding areas, that is known as the mountain. Okay, then the mountains have the sides, okay, steep sides are known as the slopes. Okay, then mountain, the tip of the mountain is called the peak. Which is the highest peak children in the world? That is Mount Everest. Mount Everest, how much height? 8848 meters. Okay, then the mountains, the Himalaya, for example, the Himalaya mountain, generally the mountains generally do not stand alone. Okay, we found the mountains along with chains. Okay, so it is known as the mountain ranges, the Himalayan mountain range. It is the highest mountain range in the world. Then other mountain ranges are the Alps in Europe, the Rockies in the North America, and is in the South America. Then also we learned children, we learned about the hills. Compared to the mountain, the hills are smaller and the lower. Then valley, the lowland between the two mountains or hills, it is known as the valleys. The Kashmir Valley, it is in the India. It is the most beautiful valley, okay, in the world. Then children, also we learned about the plateaus. Okay, what are the plateaus? Plateaus are the high land with the flat top, flat and broad top children. Okay, then the plateaus also have the steep sides. Then plateaus also known as the tablelands. Why these are known as the tablelands children? The plateaus look like a table. Okay, and the plateau, it is a leveled area of the land, plain at the top and broad. That's why the plateaus are called the tablelands. Then the highest plateau, which is the highest plateau in the world children? That is the plateau of Tibet. Okay, the plateau of Tibet, it is the highest plateau in the world. That's why it is known as the roof of the world. It is in the north of the Himalayas. Other plateau children, other plateaus are the Deccan Plateau. Yes, the Deccan Plateau, it covers the almost entire South India. It covers almost the entire Indian Peninsula. Then the Chota Nagpur Plateau, okay, it is also in the India. Then Pamir Plateau, it is in the Central Asia. Then today we discussed also about a plains children. What are the plains? Plains are flat, okay, flat land with the gentle slopes. We take example of the rivers flowing from the mountains, okay, mountains, and bring the fertile soil to the plains. Therefore the plains have more fertile and most populated areas. I gave the example, that is northern plains children. Okay, the northern plains, it is northern plains children. Northern plains are formed by the river Ganga, which is originate in the Himalayan mountain. Okay, so today in this class we discussed about the mountains, plateaus and the plains. Children, now take down the new words. Okay, here how to write your homework book children. Okay, HW, new words. The first one, mountains, then second one, slopes, valley, Rockies, then fifth one, Himalayas, sixth one, flatus, then seven children, plains, eighth, Deccan plateau, then next tributaries, tenth, deposit, broad, surrounding, children, these new words we have to write two times in your homework book. Okay, then take down the homework. Children, write these new words 5 times and read the lesson. It is a today's homework. Okay, shall I repeat? The new words are the first one: mountains, slopes, valley, Rockies, Himalayas, plateaus, plains, Deccan plateau, tributaries, deposit, broad, surrounding. Children, homework is the first one: write new words 5 times and read the lesson. Okay, so homework, today's homework, children, write new words 5 times, then read the lesson. Thank you. Have a nice day.